Hello dear student, today we are starting our new chapter, that is chapter number 3, human reproduction, from class 12th. Yes, human reproduction is the third chapter of from class 12th. Okay, now in this chapter what we consider the following topic. What was that topic? That topic are the male reproductive system, the female reproductive system, gametogenesis, menstruation cycle, fertilization and implantation, pregnancy of embryonic development, and pasteurization and lactation. So, reproduction is the process of giving birth to their young one, which are identical to their parent as well. All are aware of the process of reproduction in human is sexual reproduction, which involve fertilization by the sexual intercourse. Now we are discussing about human reproductive system. Human reproductive system, that means its first part is male reproductive system. See, the male reproductive system, generally if we talk about the male reproductive system, the human reproductive system divided into 7 steps. The first one is gametogenesis, second one insemination, the third one fertilization, fourth one blastocyst and development, fifth one implantation, sixth one embryonic development, and seventh one pasteurization. Okay, now we are starting the first one, that is male reproductive system. If we talk about male reproductive system, generally male reproductive system divided into 4 main parts. What parts? The first one testes, the second one accessory duct, the third one gland, and the fourth one external genitalia. Okay, the fourth one external genitalia. Now we are discussing detail about the male reproductive system. Saw the diagram. See the diagram of male reproductive system. Okay, generally the view of male reproductive tissue system shown in a diagram. The second diagram show the male reproductive internal part or opening detail. Okay, first we discuss about testes, situated in the pelvic region outside the body cavity with a pouch called scrotum. This is the place where scrotum are present. In scrotum is a small muscular sac that contain and protect the testes. It is a part of external male genital and it locate behind the penis. Testes are placed outside the abdominal cavity so as the mean temperature is 2 to 2.5 degree lower than the body temperature. See the temperature, 2 to 2.5 degree lower than the body temperature. Then the average body temperature, the lower temperature in testes required for spermatogenesis as the normal human body temperature can be led to mutation in the sperm. Testes is ovulin shape. It is generally 4.5 cm long and 2 cm width. Each testes has 250 compartment called testicular lobes. What they call? They call testicular lobes. Each lobule contain 1 to 3 highlighted coiled, that it called seminiferous tubule. The seminiferous tubule are the site of meiosis that led to the formation of spermatozoa. The inner lignin of spermatozoa tubule consists of two type of cell, that is called spermatogonia and sertoid cell. The spermatogenesis are the immature male germ cell that undergo meiosis that led to formation of sperm. Each sperm or spermatogonia is diploid and consists of 46 chromosomes. Sertoid cell provide nutrition to the spermatogonia. The initiating space, there are region outside the seminiferous tubule that contain small blood vessels, some immunocompartment cell and interstellar cell or the Leydig cell. The Leydig cell, they are cells that synthesize and secrete testicular hormone that is called androgen. Okay, Now we are discussing about the accessory duct. If we discuss about the accessory duct, that means the accessory duct are the transport the sperm from the testis to the urethra for their releasing outside the body. There are four accessory duct in a male reproductive system: red testis, vaso efferentia, epididymis or vaso differentia, red testis. They are duct that connect the seminiferous tubule, the testis to have valve efferentia. The vaso efferentia, the duct leave the testis open into epididymis that is located in the posterior surface of the each testis. Epididymis, it is located on the posterior surface of each testis and open into the vaso differentia. Vaso differentia is the duct that ascending in the abdominal cavity loop over the urinary bladder. It receive a duct from the seminal vessels and open into urethra. Ejected duct, the store and transport the sperm from the testes to the outside through the urethra. Urethra, it is the thin muscular tube. It is originated from the urinary bladder. It passes through the penis to the external opening called urethra mater. Accessory gland, there are three accessory gland that are seminivascular, prostatic gland and bulbatory gland. The gland are secreted, produce a mix with the sperm to nourish and protect them. The seminal vessels, they contribute approximately 60-70% of the fluid in semen. They secrete are rich in the protein, enzyme, fructose, vitamin C, phosphocholine, prostatic gland. The high fructose contain providing nourishment energy from the spermatozoa. The prostate gland is secrete a slightly alkaline milky fluid. This help in the survival of sperm in the acid vaginal environment. Secretion also improve the motility of the sperm. Okay, now the next gland is bulbourethral gland. This secrete the gland lubricate the penis and nourish any residual acidity in the urethra. Now the next topic is female reproductive system. What we discuss, female reproductive system. The human female reproductive system is specialized to support the process of gametogenesis, is ovulation, fertilization, pregnancy, birth and child care. The part of female reproductive system are, I am repeating again, the human female reproductive system is specialized to support the process of gametogenesis, ovulation, fertilization, pregnancy, birth, child care, etc. Human reproductive system are a pair of ovary, a pair of ovary duct, urethra, cervix, vagina, external gonital or mammary gland. Okay, generally female reproductive system are consist seven pairs, that is a pair of ovary, a pair of ovary duct, urethra, cervix, vagina, external genitals or mammary gland. Okay, in next class we are discussing detail about female reproductive system. What we will discuss in our next class, female reproductive system. Till then you make your notes of male reproductive system. Okay, so goodbye student, take care, have a nice day. Now, so please read the topic male reproductive system and try to understand that topic and also learn the female reproductive system. We will consider this topic in our next video. So take care, have a nice day.